Nice to see you again. Welcome to La Zagaleta.
Thank you so much. I'm so happy to be in this paradise. I love being here. The feeling, the atmosphere, I love this place. It's totally peaceful and it's a dream.
Thank you. Of course, you're here to talk about Starlite. And we're very curious to see what these the latest developments. If you're happy overall, I think you're celebrating the 11th anniversary.
Yeah, this year is the 12th.
The 12th anniversary. Everybody in Marbella knows it. I think most people, not only in Marbella, but also in Spain and Costa del Sol, are extremely grateful for the festival and the level that you have brought, and in particular the cities can be very proud of you. You must have worked like really, really hard over so many years. Tell us a bit about that.
Yeah, I've been working very hard, but I have had so much fun. I really enjoy. It was not so bad at the end, you know. I mean, it was a big effort in all sense, because in the beginning we were bringing super big stars, and it took a time for people to realize that we were doing concerts in the middle of the forest, in the mountain. Even it's 10 minutes from the center of Marbella, but in the beginning it was not that easy. But now, I mean, we are so happy with what we have built, that there are people coming from 95 nationalities, and they are the biggest artists coming, like Rod Stewart, Elton John, Lenny Kravitz, Andrea Bocelli, Julio Iglesias, Enrique Iglesias, Lionel Richie, I mean, you name it, but Maluma, and Nora Jones is coming next week. I mean, it's really happening, and people come to spend time in Marbella, also checking our lineup to combine it with the vacations.
Fantastic, yes, it's really impressive. Sandra, please tell us how it all started, the very beginning. How did you start this?
I've been working with stars all my life long, since I was 20. I was studying and I was already traveling all around the world with big artists and celebrities, doing endorsement campaigns, bringing and matching brands with stars, and also bringing stars to do concerts in Middle East and in South America and in the United States, all over. And it came to a point that my husband, when I met him, we started dating. It was many years ago. And then he came to a point and said, you should build your own festival, and the artist comes to you, and it will be like a meeting point. And that's what happened. Starlite is like a community, like a family. Most of the artists are friends because we have been working for a long time, and we get together. And many requests to be, please, could you find us that we could stay at Zagaleta? And we said, okay, I talk with Ignacio to see if we can find something. But big artists, they heard about Zagaleta, and they want also to come here. So it's a good match. They have the peace here, and they have the party, and the nights and the fun and the drinks at Starlite.
Okay, many people, when they talk about Starlite, we remember the beginnings and the name of course, a very, very Spanish actor, Antonio Banderas, was a crucial person in that moment. Because is it correct to say that it started as a philanthropic business, but it evolved also as a business?
Exactly. In the beginning, it was a charity gala that Antonio Banderas and me started together. And this was 2010, and it was so successful, people coming, I mean, it was really, everybody wanted to be here with many stars. We had Deepak Chopra coming, and we honored him in the beginning, and we had when was Michelle Obama came, and it was in all the press, and we did the first gala, then we did the second, and it came to a point that we thought, Antonio and me were talking, like, the biggest galas in the world are surrounded by a big event. For example, ANFAR is in the middle of Cannes Film Festival, or the Elton John Gala is during the Oscars, or Person of the Year is when you have the Grammys. So we thought, why don't we do a concert the day before and one the day after? And then it's a business, the concerts, we pay for that, we have a structure, but it will support the charity gala so that we have the artists already there, we have the clients that come, the big clients that will, and the people that will come and will pay the tickets for the gala, and then we could ask for all the drinks for free, and the lighting for free, and the whole structure that we need, the person working for free, because at the end, it's a company that will pay for the concert. And then we said, okay, let's do the concert. We support everything, we finance everything, and at the end, all the money that we raise goes directly to the foundations and to the projects. And suddenly, all the artists wanted to come, all the artists wanted to perform, and we end up doing a whole festival. Then my husband in the beginning couldn't understand, like, let's choose the best performances, the best musician, artist, and just do these concerts. I said, like, I cannot, they all want to come. We do many concerts, at the end we had them all. And see, well, now 3 months.
How are you coping with people trying to copy you? Because you are, it's true that you made the very first effort. You spotted now everybody wants to do festival, not only in Spain, but in Costa del Sol, in almost every holiday destination. And what are you doing to remain different and to be the front, stay at the forefront and to be competitive? What's if you want to reveal this?
Yeah, of course.
What is your formula to stay always so much in advance?
First of all, we have an amazing team. They work with us. People live the whole year thinking how to surprise, how to make happy the audience that will come to visit us. And we reinvent ourselves every year. The hill of 1 year is the floor of the next year, so we always want to go one step further to continue growing and reinventing ourselves. And we always looking for the wow. This is a wow, or it's not a wow. So, and when we plan the restaurants, the gastronomy, the performances, everything, we are thinking how to make people happy, how will we surprise and receive a wow from the audience. And there is more than 1,000 festivals in Spain. It's the country who has more festivals, but Starlite is the same as Zagaleta. Everybody wants to copy you, but you're the number ones. Why? Because the way of doing things, putting the soul in what we are doing, and putting a lot of energy, putting enthusiasm, and at the end, this is the result, our products. We have different products, but our products has excellency. We do things with a lot of love and with soul. We do the things different, in a different way. Just not how all the rest do it. We don't follow. We are not followers. We are leaders. We reinvent our fields. We reinvent how people are consuming music in giving another experience. And you're reinventing how people live to give them a beautiful life. And that's why we match so well, because we go to the same audience.
Yes, we can read that you're also investing a lot of in technology, in the stage. You are a front runner as well, because on one side you have very successful actors, singers, and then on the other side you have very demanding crowd, right? That's paying ticket to be there, and you also have to. What is your latest technique? Can you reveal something about when you go there and you see the stage, it's so impressive. The light, the sound, the quality of the sound, everything is just like a world class.
Yeah, and this year we also put a big focus in gastronomy. We have 4 restaurants, so you have sushi, you could have like Japanese, or you can have Mexican, or you can have caviar and oysters. But regarding the sound, This year we have the most amazing pioneer sound that you can imagine. The German engineers come to do the testing of what would be in the Sphere. You know the Sphere, Madison Square Garden in Las Vegas? It's this big a ball, like a world, in the middle, bigger than all the buildings, and so on. It's something amazing that the whole industry is looking for that, because it's $2 billion investment in doing this place, and it's something with incredible technology. The sound of this is now in Starlite. It's the first place in the world they are testing it. And the unique thing is that everybody listen in stereo, no matter where you are in stereo, and everybody listen in the same volume. The potence is the same for everybody, because it's speakers that goes directly to each person on the audience. It's unbelievable. It's like the sound involves you, and when you move, it's like following you. It's something really, really incredible, and it's an experience.
Sandra, are you happy with your overall philanthropic contribution to the world? And can you tell us something about this? What has been the most proud philanthropic work that you have done? I know it's throughout the year, but can you give us some your thoughts about this?
It's what fulfills me more, and it's what I feel more proud in my entire life. No Starlite, not the group, not everything that we are doing professionally, but the foundation, because we are changing so many lives, give so many opportunities, and really, I mean, we have built 27 schools in Mexico. This is thousands of children that are changing the whole community, and they will have another life that was planned for them. And here we're doing a lot of things in Malaga with Antonio, because he's from here and he wants to do a lot for his people. We are we're helping a foundation that is called Caritas. We are doing also with cancer disease and cancer treatments. We are also giving scholarships. We are involved in a lot of projects with the community to support people that don't have opportunities, to give them opportunities and changing their lives. We really think it's not about giving food, but showing them or giving them tools to get the food, or in giving them tools to conquer another life that what they have expected or what were possible for them when they didn't have the education or the preparation or when they were in another level. Mm.
Sandra, it's not so easy to talk about philanthropy. It's because it's a complex world. First, when you want to help, you need to know who to help, how to help, and lots of things. And how can you have someone who helps you for that? Or I mean, you must have someone, some advisors, because it's a world apart. Just to know. We all want to help, but sometimes it's better to do it through Caritas or through another non-profit organization. Who is helping you with that?
There are many people supporting us and helping us, many artists, many celebrities, that they don't have the time, but they want to have somebody that they trust and projects that they can come and see them. And they many of them have visited our schools. Many of them has come to see where the money goes, to see the projects themselves. And many businessmen also, they want to help. They don't have the time to encourage the money to do the projects. And they come to us and said, I want to support this, or I want to do this project. Could you help me put this together? Could you help us? And we have a whole team working in helping them doing their dreams in this side, the things that they want to fulfill. We are helping them to fulfill their expectations, and the way they want to help, through encouraging it through our foundation, and it's working very well. At the end, I think most of the people, once they have achieved enough money, enough success, enough things to surround and to fulfill their life, they want to give back, and they want to do things for the others, to leave a legacy here in this world. Most of the people that have succeeded and has achieved their goals in life, it comes to a point that they want to give back, they want to help, and they want to leave a legacy and to feel that once they left this world, something stays, and the path of them through this world has made a sense. I mean, has created something, has changed and improved and make a difference for others.
Sandra, would you say that Starlite is the leading boutique festival company or enterprise in the world, or how would you?
I mean, the press normally said that we are the leading or the best boutique festival in the world, but what I say and what I realize is that we make a lot of people happy. Last year we had 350,000 people coming to our venue, but very premium boutique, like 3,000 every time. So people have the opportunity to be very close to the artists, the mountain, the energy of the space, and it's an experience. What we are giving, I really feel that Starlite is like a therapy. You go into our space for a few hours, and when you go out, you feel so full of energy, so full of enthusiasm, so happy that it potents the best part of you. I mean, it's like a mystic process that I cannot explain. But when you go, I mean, you have been in Starlite. Everybody goes happy, laughing, very, it's like having a bath of happiness.
Absolutely. So what do you see, Sandra? Where do you see yourself in 10 years' time? I mean, the success in the first 11 years.
Yeah.
And now, and I mean, where can you take it to?
I mean, somebody that has always inspired me a lot is Walt Disney. And he created a whole world in the theme parks with the cartoons and with the characters, Mickey Mouse and all these things. And what we are building is also a place in our main thing is music, but it's also art, it's fashion. And these are languages that are common to everybody. Everybody understands each other through music, brings the feeling out, makes the soul and the emotions come out, and brings the child that is in us. So we want to build something that will make a lot of people happy. That's what we are building.
Sandra, I have heard that you're going to do a Starlite Festival in Madrid as well, and eventually also in other places of the world, abroad. Can you tell us something about this?
Yeah, we have a few proposals on the table to do Starlite abroad in other countries. We are open. Why not? We did in Mexico in 2016. And this year we are going to Madrid. We are doing Christmas by Starlite, that is bringing the whole idea of Starlite, bringing it to Madrid and constructing exactly the same thing, but for Christmas. I hope you come and enjoy it with me one night at least. You should organize yourself. I would love to have you there. It's going to be really very magical, because I think magic is a word that identify very much with Starlite. Dreams, magic, emotions, and Christmas is a time when all the emotions go out and all the good things, and it's a very special time of the year, and we want to keep making dreams true and keep making people happy, and through music, through artists, and through the experience that we offer.
Yes, and Madrid is a very vibrant city as well, and I'm sure you'll be going to be very successful in this venture.
Thank you. Yeah, I'm sure Madrid is going to be very exciting and very special and very magical, and I hope we can celebrate together in Madrid this Christmas.
I'm sure we will. Sandra, tell us a bit about your husband. Is he helping you behind the scenes, or how would you describe his role? Because I know he's involved, but he's doing other business as well, and I know he has passion for Starlite, yeah, as well.
My husband is the person in the shadow, but he's always supporting me. He likes that I shine. He's the most intelligent man I ever met. He's super smart, and he supported me from the beginning. Actually, he sold his company 12 years ago. He's now with other projects and so also, but at that time he sold his telecommunication engineer. He created all the lights, the green and red lights in the parking spaces, and when he got this all around the world in 49 countries, he sold the company, and he said, okay, now you do this festival, you bring all the stars together in Marbella, and I put the money to do this. And I said, great, accept it, it's a good idea, thank you so much for financing it, but I want you to support me not only with money. You are very smart, you have to put the plan together. He's a visionary, he also does the whole strategy, he's very good with numbers, and he's always there with me, but more in the shadow.
Well, send him our best regards.
And I will. We are a great team.
Thank you to you.
A big thank you to you. I think we are very complementary. Zagaleta and us, we are very strong brands. We are very prestige brands. And at the same time, it's like the night and the day. We are the fun, the party, the glamours, the drinks, the alcohol, the music. And you are the peaceful, the beautiful, the most amazing, the heaven is like heaven, and we are sometimes more like the other side, the crazy. No, so it's very combining. And when you are having a lot of fun, you need also the time to recover. And here, you recover and recharge energy, and you spend the energy in Starlite.
Thank you, Sandra. Thank you so much for your time. It was such a pleasure to have you here. Congratulations for everything you're doing and everybody you're helping as well from a philanthropic point of view. And a big, big thank you from Marbella and from the Zagaleta community. We're very happy to have you here.
Thank you.